Today we are talking about the wonderful magic of masking fluid. Hey gang, welcome back. My name is Shada and this is a Shada Short. We're gonna do some mini episodes and we'll get right to the point. Today we're talking about using masking fluid. This is what mine looks like. It's a common art supply and you can purchase it on Amazon or at most art stores. We're gonna open it up and dip an old or an inexpensive brush in there. It's basically liquid latex, so keep your good brushes away from it. And then we're going to apply it to any area of the page that you don't want the paint to go. So it's going to protect the paper completely and no paint is getting through this stuff. It can be a bit gummy and sticky. To avoid lumps, try not to shake it. Add just a little water if you need to, and do your best not to go over the same area more than once. While the masking fluid is drying, you can mix up your watercolor paints. Today I'm working with a palette of peaches and pinks, and I have a nice watery paint. And then that mask dries quite quickly, so you can take your paint and go over the area where you've laid down the masking fluid. You can do a simple wash like I'm doing, or you can do something really intricate. You can even leave the masking fluid on for a long time if you're working on a painting that's going to take you a while. It will completely protect the page underneath, and eventually you can remove it and you'll have nice, clean paper. Add as much paint and water as you like. You can play around with wet into wet like I'm doing here, releasing a bit more pigment into my wet area, and I don't have to worry about painting right over top of my masked out portion. It's also worth mentioning that you can use masking fluid over top of paint. If you have an area of the painting that you want to protect, wait for it to dry and then apply. With our painting done, I'm going to rinse my brush and just let everything rest and dry completely. Once it has dried, the painting will be dry and the masking fluid might be a little tacky or sticky to the touch. At that point, you can use your finger and begin to lift it up. It's kind of like peeling a gum eraser. It lifts up nicely and you can see the area underneath is completely protected and it's just a nice white page. There's so many uses for this masking fluid. As I said, you can apply it over a painted area. What you do with it is totally up to you and your creativity.